testimony that you're about to witness is true. This is a client of Kahan Tazadaq's that discharged already over $25,000 in debt using the EFC method. I'll say less and allow him to speak for himself. He did not want to disclose his name, so he will remain anonymous. Listen in, and then be sure to click the link below this video and order these books and become a secure party creditor now. And order the book that he used, Liberate the Oppressed. To this, the $20,000 debt that you discharged by using the EFT method, you learned that from Liberate the Oppressed, Tazadaq's book. Which book did you use for that?
Liberate the Oppressed.
And how long ago did you discharge that $20,000 debt?
It's probably been about a year, because when I learned the process from you, I had broken my Achilles tendon. So I believe Yahweh set me down to learn that process.
Now, let me ask you this. Now, if you've been doing this correctly, you only do this on closed accounts. You understand that, right? You can't leave the account open.
Right.
For educational purposes, the account is closed. An EFT is only used for settlement and closure. You understand that, right?
Right.
You can't use it if you have an account at a credit union. You understand that?
Right.
If you do an EFT on a credit card, the alleged debt will go back on the card because you did not close the account up. You understand that?
I believe I do, but go ahead.
You can't keep a credit card open that you EFT. That account is done. EFT, again, is only for closed accounts.
Right. Okay. Yes. I'm with you.
All right, so
Yes. Besides
the $20,000 debt discharge, what other one did you have success with? Well, $20,000, was that through a car dealer or something? That's a large debt.
No, that was a personal loan.
Okay, so it was a loan.
Yeah, unsecured.
All right, so what about the other ones?
Okay, the other one, it was like an upgrade. It was a credit card, and that one was like $3,200.
Okay. How long ago did you discharge that one?
That's probably been about the same time, about a year, maybe a year, 3 months.
You use EFT process on that as well? All right.
Okay. And then, of course, this one that I'm working on now, it was $3,800. And, of course, you know, I closed that one out. So what else did I use it on?
When you're sending off these EFTs, are you putting a copy of the codes in there? House Joint Resolution?
Yes.
UCC 3.603B?
Yes.
Okay.
My correspondence.
All right. So, and you're giving them a deadline, right? Now, this is the thing that I try to get folks to remember. If it works for one, then it should work for all. Do you agree on that? So, the reason that it's not working is because it's not that it's not working. It already worked because acceptance forms a binding contract. And if I put in my contractual obligation an allotted deadline that they have to respond, and if they don't respond within that allotted time, the alleged debt is settlement and closure, then there's discharge. They kept the instrument, they didn't respond within the allotted time, there's a binding contract. I could take that to court at the three correspondents and get a default judgment against them. It's not a damn thing they could do about it. Because there's a contract here, you see?
Okay. Yeah.
They had a deadline to respond. If they failed to meet that deadline, just like us, now you go to court and you get a default judgment against them. beautiful when short distance.
The law. Kahan, okay. All right. Yeah, that was going to be my other question. I have never taken anybody to court. And I've been buying books to figure out, like, the federal rules of procedure.
You get those from the court that you're going into. You get those for the court that you're going into. Each court may have different rules. So you get it from the court that you're going to actually go into.
Okay, do you get that from the clerk?
Yeah, you can get it from the clerk. Sometimes it's on the websites. But you could ask the clerk.
Okay, all right. I just want to make sure I'm doing everything correctly if I have to go into a colorful venue. I want to make sure I got a suit with plastic buttons.
All right.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
Man. So it's just simply the correspondence, man. And that's what I find that most people think about it. You discharge a $20,000 alleged debt, but the ones for $3,000 something's giving you a problem. Man, he's been paid. Did he keep it? I ask you one thing: did he keep it? And what if he didn't keep it?
Yeah.
UCC 3-603B. Even if it's refused, there's discharge. If only more people believe.
Oh, I'm in it. I'm so in it. I don't know how many books I've been ordered from you now, and I'm getting ready to order those other two more, the credit and whatever that other new one that you came out with as well.
So the traffic one? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, traffic and the credit, yeah.
Ruined the plot, shot the courts and cop. Huh.
Yeah, even though the Liberate the Oppressed tells you, within the first 72 hours what to do, but I want all your information.
Yeah, this has different remedies for those that can't get in the first 72 hours, you see?
Oh, really?
Yes.
Wow.
This tells you what Tazadaq says when he goes in, how to cross-examine the police officer and walk. And the credit privacy numbers in that credit book.
Oh, CPN?
Yep.
Man, that's good news right there. Wow, okay. All right.
When people have success like you, they should come on and give a testimony because it gives more other people the faith and hope to be able to move forward. A lot of people don't do this stuff out of fear.
Right, right. And that's the thing, Kahan. I'm tired of being afraid. Because being afraid doesn't do anything. And then when it's all said and done, it's just pieces of paper. Of course, the pieces of paper can bind you up. But if you have right knowledge, you're good.
Yep. Kahan, hashtag Tazadaq Doctrine. Google Tazadaq. I bet you didn't know that less than 1/10 of people that's actually attended some sort of form of higher education discharge the alleged student loan debts. What about you? What's preventing you from getting Kahan Tazadaq's books by visiting www.truedisciplesofchrist.org/shop and ordering all of his books, books that would typically cost you thousands of dollars if you try to purchase certain law books. Click the link below even more so that you could actually attend this up-and-coming webinar April the 22nd and 23rd from 12 noon to 6 p.m. by clicking the link below and registering for this webinar. Why are you not discharging these student loan debts and these other alleged debts? Attend this webinar and get this right knowledge now. This is